The new Public Service Pensions Fund Bill of 2023, which is before Parliament, requires every public servant to make a mandatory contribution of 5% of his or her gross salary to the pension fund every month, and then the government will contribute 10% of the employee's gross salary, unlike currently where the government contributes 100% of the pension to the public servant's retirement package. However, leaders of different labor unions under the National Organization of Trade Unions, NOTU, who appeared before the Parliamentary Committee of Local Government and Public Service, called for harmonization of the bill, saying the government has to first consider salary enhancement of public servants across the board before going ahead to cut 5% of their pay. Trade unions also want the government to amend the NSSF Act to have public servants contribute their pension to NSSF.
The point is, currently the public service workers are the lowest paid in this country. If you compare them with workers in government, parastatals, in the authorities, the mainstream public servant and local government workers are the lowest paid. So, if this deduction, which is going to be a contribution to this fund, is affected, this worker is going to be affected very, very negatively. So we are thinking that since these workers had already negotiated with government and reached a collective agreement to enhance salaries, let government do that, enhance the salaries, so that when the deductions come, workers will contribute comfortably to this fund.
According to government, the Public Service Pension Fund will be run and operated just like the private sector's NSSF fund, which also provides for 5% contribution by the employee and 10% contribution by the employer. But workers claim there is no need for duplication of roles when NSSF is already proven.
When you look at this NSSF already the members are very few. We have only 2 million people. And why should we start another fund? It is important that we can use the same structure which we have already, built, and the same fund to recruit other members by joining the public service pension.
When we talk about investment out of members' monies, how do the members benefit from the what? From the investments, the normal members that they debated. And we also went as far as looking at what they were proposing that would be done. Because you can't use my money for an investment, and then maybe the employer takes charge of what accrues from the what? The investment.
NOTU also wants public servants to start receiving their pension in a lump sum instead of monthly contributions, which the bill suggests.
I will tell you, I want my money to start a business. Now, if you are going to give me my money as a monthly installment, it will not facilitate me to carry on the business that has to keep me in retirement. I don't want to overemphasize this point. You have seen the suffering that the pensioners go through.
They cannot reach offices. They got the banks. They can't even access banks. They can't, you know, they are too old, most of them, to access even how to withdraw their money. They are cheated. And as you are aware, most of their monies have always been embezzled.
There are about 350,000 public servants on active payroll at local government, ministries, departments and agencies. The proposed scheme will include all public servants with the exception of UPDF officers and lecturers of public universities who have their own schemes. Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.